Now the South.
You know, obviously, the Lakers struggling a bit, but, you know, anytime you go against the Rockets, especially when he's at stake, and he turns into triple-double, so it's had a poor night.
Yeah,
so,
I mean, whenever the Purple and Gold come into town, you know, their fans travel well, and they add one of the generational players in our league, you know, you're definitely going to have a nice fan base and a nice group of crowd or fans supporting him here, but I think our fans came out and showed up as well, and I think that made the difference. Last year was a little bit more lopsided when teams like the Lakers would come in here, so I'm definitely really proud of our fans for coming and showing out like they did tonight.
I saw you were kind of egging them on there when
you
got your fifth foul.
Yeah, I mean, because that helps us out at the end. You know, you might not want to get involved, but sometimes that energy, that little extra energy, you receive an extra effort to win the game sometimes.
And John, I was really expecting for you to release the details of your dunk contest, what you got in mind, but what's the easiest way to describe what we like to see?
I think it's sort of similar to the dunks you're going to see in the game, sort of. I try to use that sort of explosiveness. You know, that's obviously when I'm jumping the highest. Yeah, I think that's sort of as much as I can give you. You're gonna see, you know, that explosion or that sort of same sort of jump that I jump in games with, just so I can, you know, jump as high as I can and try to get to win.
Now, does a win of this magnitude do something, I guess, like different from a confidence standpoint? Hosting the Knicks on Thursday, how do you kind of like assure yourself that you won't overlook them?
I mean, I feel like at this point, you know, I know how to just, you know, sort of clear out everything, calm the mind down, and focus on that one game. Obviously, I've been practicing, so I've, you know, try to put a little bit of time into, you know, working on it, and then so we don't have other time to clear my mind and focus on the job at hand, the task at hand, you know, the Knicks. So I don't think it's gonna be too big of a problem.
22 points for yourself tonight, 22 points for Trae Young. Can you talk to us a little bit just about the chemistry that you guys have developed over the season? It seems to be getting stronger with each game.
Yeah, I mean, I just think the more we play on the court together, the better the chemistry is going to get. Obviously, like you said, both of us scoring the ball well tonight, but I think he did a really good job of facilitating, you know, like a possession or a string of possessions in the second quarter where he was just finding everybody. I think more than scoring, that's going to help him out a lot. But, yeah, we're definitely going to have the best pick and roll chemistry in the league for years to come. So, I love playing with that dude.
John, you know, Trae Young is learning very strong bigs, and you had LeBron tonight. What was it like? Can you walk us through what it's like guarding him? Is it any different?
Yeah, sure. It's different because, you know, he can affect the game in a lot of ways. You know, his passing ability, so strong, as we mentioned, him getting to the cup. And I think we just tried to do a better job of showing him a crowd, trying to make him finish through multiple bodies, you know, with a guy that strength and that magnitude. Like I said, when you play against him, nothing really changes. It's just more your intensity and how much you need to be locked in needs to change a little bit. And I think it's a pretty solid job.